Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel.
So in this video I will discuss about the pleural effusion.
What is pleural effusion and what are the causes and how to treat it, everything. So let's get started. First introduction. Pleural effusion is a collection of fluid in the pleural space and is rarely a primary disease process, but it is usually secondary to mainly other diseases like the tuberculosis and other pneumonia and all. So pleural effusion is the collection of fluid in the pleural space. And which is the pleural space? Pleural space is between the parietal pleura and the visceral pleura in around our lungs. And this pleural effusion is rarely a primary disease process. And this pleural effusion usually occurs secondary to some other conditions like tuberculosis, pneumonia, etc. So the pleural space normally contains only about 10 to 20 ml of serous fluid. So to clinically detect a pleural effusion, at least 200 ml of fluid must be present in the pleural space. Normally, there is only 10 to 20 ml of serous fluid, which is easily circulated inside the pleural space. So pleural fluid normally seeps continually into the pleural space from the capillaries lining the parietal pleura and is reabsorbed by the visceral pleura, pleural capillaries and lymphatic system. So normally the pleural fluid remains constant, that is 10 to 20 ml, because it is continually seeping into the pleural space from the capillaries of the parietal pleura, and that pleural fluid is again reabsorbed by the visceral pleural capillaries and by the lymphatic system. So the pleural fluid normally does not get increased. But in any condition, any disease condition like tuberculosis or pneumonia or other disease condition like rheumatoid arthritis, and there are many disease conditions like after cardiac failure, liver failure. So any condition that interferes with either secretion or drainage of this fluid leads to pleural effusion. So any condition which interferes with either the secretion of the pleural fluid from the parietal pleura and drainage of this fluid, pleural fluid, from the visceral, by the visceral pleura, leads to pleural effusion. So the parietal pleura secretes the pleural fluid and the visceral pleura drains it, reabsorbs it. Okay, so any condition which will affects this secretion and drainage process, which will affects more in increase, more, which will increase the secretion of pleural fluid and which will decrease the drainage of pleural fluid, will leads to pleural effusion. So let us continue. So the definition of pleural effusion is a collection of abnormal amount of fluid in the pleural space. So the collection of abnormal amount of pleural fluid in the pleural space is known as pleural effusion. Abnormal amount means more than 10 to 20 ml, and it is detectable by the X-ray only if there is 200 ml of fluid in the pleural space. There are two types of pleural effusions: transudative effusion and exudative effusions. You all know the transudative. Transudative means there is no protein in the fluid and the cell count is also low. But in exudative effusions, protein is very high and the cell count is also very high. So first of all, let us discuss about this process, these effusions individually. The transudative effusions, okay? I will explain you very clearly. The transudative effusions, we all know, will occur when the hydrostatic pressure will get increased, okay? And we all know that when hydrostatic pressure get increased, the fluid will go out, okay? The fluid will go out from the capillaries, okay? And it occurs primarily in non-inflammatory conditions, and is an accumulation of low protein and low cell count fluid, because there is only increase in hydrostatic pressure and there is no increase in gap in between the endothelium in case of transudative effusions. And it is mainly in non-inflammatory conditions like liver failure, cardiac failure, renal failure. Those non-inflammatory conditions like cardiac failure, liver failure and renal failure will lead to transudative effusions, which means the fluid will be in low protein, will have low protein and will have low cell count in the pleural fluid. Hope the transudative effusion is clear for you all. And if it is not clear, please comment on the comment section below. I will try to explain it through a diagram. For the time being, please Please subscribe my channel to continue the video and to get the updates regularly. So next we have discussed the transudative effusions. Now let us discuss about the exudative effusions. But before that, let us discuss about the cause of transudative effusion. I have already told you that increase in hydrostatic pressure found in heart failure, most common cause of pleural effusion, and decrease oncotic pressure from hypoalbuminemia found in cirrhosis of liver or renal disease. In this condition, fluid movement is facilitated out of the capillaries and into the pleural space. So the fluid will move out of the capillaries into the pleural space. In case of exudative effusions, it occurs in an area of inflammation and is an accumulation of high protein fluid, just opposite of the transudative effusions. An exudative effusion results from increased capillary permeability, characteristic of inflammatory reaction. This type of effusion occurs secondary to conditions such as pulmonary malignancies, pulmonary infections, and pulmonary embolism. I hope the transudative and exudative effusions are clear for the time being. I will discuss the latter part later. Thank you, and if you find the video helpful, please subscribe my channel. I will try to make some other videos. Thank you.